Alright, so this is Fear 3. And basically what we're doing with Fear 3 is we're sort of reimagining the franchise and adding co-op to it. And in this case, the brothers, Fettel and Point Man, find themselves in this pretty ugly section, pretty dangerous section, down beneath a bridge with a bunch of paranormal characters called scavengers. Work our way through here. What we try to do with this level is give that feeling like you're alone in the basement. The scavengers can attack you from any angle, and you really have to rely on each other as brothers. What makes this area really special and sort of unique is that if Fettel chooses to, there's a number of assets through here that he can use or see that doesn't have to tell Point Man about. And that makes it very difficult for Point Man if Fettel chooses to sort of pander to his personality. Oh man, there's a lot of them. Nice. So Fettel's gonna try and basically hold that guy up and, so that I can shoot him. And part of our scoring system allows us to, if we choose to play together, be rewarded for that. And if we choose to play apart or not working cooperatively, we're rewarded for that in unique ways. Give me a hand with this guy. I got him. Nice. So what's truly interesting about this is that we don't know where they're going to come from, even though we've played this level a number of times. Thanks to our generative system, we're never exactly sure where they're going to attack from. Or when. Oh, I got him. Like a slow-mo. Shotgun. Nice. And in this case, we decided to work together, and Fettel actually used my slow-mo ability as Point Man to create this massive thunderclap and destroy the enemy. Another one here. I got him, I'm coming. Nice. One of the scary things about the scavengers is they can attack from any direction. They can walk on the ceiling, they can walk on the walls. You're never sure where they're gonna be coming from. I got him. Reloading. Watch it, dude, you got one behind you. Another one. I think we got them all. So as we work our way through the space, we begin to see that we can get up top. And up top is a new and unique enemy type called the Phase Caster. And how he's particularly deadly is that he has the ability to, you know, if you played Fear 1 or Fear 2, you'll know that it's very much about seeking cover and making sure that you've got these enemies in front of you and you can aggress them. The Phase Caster can have them spawn in almost any direction at any time. Particularly nasty. So he's up there and he's launching guys in. And we have to work together to survive. I got him. Shotgun. Try and get the Phase Caster, dude. Nice. Hold him up. So Fettel's holding him up while I unload on him. But he's tough. I got a guy down here. Oh. I got him. And you can see they're everywhere. See if you can take some shots at the Phase Caster. See if I can cook a grenade up there. Another guy down here. Alright, I got the AR. There we go, I got him. We got him. Particularly deadly weapon. And you can see, thanks to our scoring system, that Fettel and I actually got in it a buff due to the fact that Fettel raised that guy out, but I could kill him. Just a matter of how you play the game. Oh, there's a second phase caster here. But dude, look, there's an EPA down there. I got it. Nice. I got him with a grenade. Oh, toast. Reloading. There's a guy over here. Let's send another bunch of guys. All right, so we got the second phase caster. Just gonna go in here and get the enhanced power armor. And this is something we really wanted to do different in Fear 3. Making sure that the power armor just wasn't a palate cleanser, it was something that, where there's a lot of risk and reward in this space. So Fettel's gonna work his way along, and it's really a matter of how you play it. If Fettel wants to, he can go up ahead and get another power armor, or choose to stay basically possessing bodies and working his way through the space on the interior of the map versus the exterior of the map. I got him. Nice. All right, I'm gonna work my way across the bridge. So once I'm in the power armor, it really gives me that feeling of satisfaction that I can sort of destroy the guys who have given me so much trouble so far. Oh, there's a chopper. Shield. Behind me. See if we can get him here. We got them. So that's your first look at Fear 3. I hope you guys like what you see. Fear 3 is coming out this fall, and it's coming out on the 360, the PS3, and PC.